Yep. So it's Purim. Happy Purim.
Chag Sameach.
Disco, disco.
I don't know. Maybe we should just be like having attention and just like clip something out of there. That was
really good.
That
was really good, especially since we don't have an intro to start the episode.
We don't have an intro.
We're starting now.
Right now.
We love you.
Hi, I'm Sarah, and this is your GNN Sports Update. One of Gann's most understated teams, the Cheese Rollers, are about to start their 47th annual Battle of the Sexes competition. Four cheese rollers will be running down a hill, chasing a wheel of cheese and trying to grab a hold of it before it reaches the bottom of the hill. Here's David at the scene.
Hello, Sarah, and yes, as you can see, the cheese race is mature. To represent the girls, we have four-time winner, freshman Michelle Eichen. She may be short, but all around her team, she's known as the Big Cheese. Also playing for the girls is senior Shara Garlick, who has yet to claim a victory. Representing the boys, we have freshman Daniel Geisberg. Also on the boys' team is senior Jonah Nagy, whose farty kick has always been the boys' golden ticket to glory.
And look at that! The boys bring home the victory with Jonah in first place. It was a close call with Sharon not too far behind, but in the end, she could not cut the cheese. As you can see, Daniel seems to have only made it halfway down the hill, and we don't really know where Michelle went. Back to you, Sarah.
Thank you, David. Well, folks, there you have it. The Battle of the Sexes has been claimed by the boys in legendary fashion. We would like to give a special thanks to our participants, Michelle, Daniel, Shara, and Jonah. Better luck next year, girls. This has been a GNN Sports Update. I'm Sarah, and thanks for watching.
Thanks, David and Sarah. Hey, Jonah, you roll that cheese, all right?
Also, Michelle, if you're out there, we're looking for you. So don't go running away like that. Come back safely.
We'll find you. Also, our next segment features something the people really want to see. It's Occupy Room 109.
All GAN classrooms have smart boards, but sometimes it can be tedious and time-consuming for teachers to get them to actually work. For one particular junior Hebrew class, the continued malfunctioning of their class smart board went too far. And so, on January 17th, 2011, during G-Block, Ruti Barak's Hebrew class up and left room 111 for Mr. Conti's Tanakh room 209, known for its new smart board, and has not left since.
We were just about to read some Richard Elliot Friedman when an entire class of juniors walked into the classroom and interrupted us. I believe their exact words were, "Everybody out, but orient the board for us." I've never seen anything like it.
Is it too much to ask for a decent Hebrew education? The only way we know we're going to have a working smart board is if the administration accepts the terms of our plan for everyone to receive a new, more user-friendly smart board. And this is not an isolated incident. The system has been tilted towards room 209 for far too long. It's the only room that isn't freezing cold in the winter and burning hot in the fall.
We haven't had class in there for weeks. I left my computer and my best coffee mug there.
Additionally, the movement has attracted students from around the school to work for the cause.
It's a revolution! I want to be able to say that I helped create smart board equality in this school. It's like all of a sudden we've been given a chance to be like those guys in the 60s. Our lives have meaning!
We're marching through the halls, carrying these really cool signs. We've got one, smart boards are a right. And, there's another one, the system needs orienting. Oh, and there's an even better one, what color are you? Oh, we didn't mean it that way.
Yeah, dude, I don't even know, like, what's going on here. I just kind of came. I saw some kids hanging out during my free block, so I just grabbed, you know, the missing guitar that I've been keeping in my locker, and, just wanted to see if anyone wanted to jam or anything. Like.
So who wants to hear Wonderwall?
I'm always looking for things that make for good pictures, and I gotta admit, this movement has something to it. You should see the way people walk by and mistreat the activists between classes. It's heartbreaking.
I don't see what's so beautiful about this ordeal. My class is suffering because of this displaced anger that the kids feel towards the administration. So my classroom has a newer smart board. Maybe if they could just suck it up and figure out how to use theirs, this wouldn't be a problem. I don't see why the administration hasn't forced an end to this already. I mean, really, Rabbi Baker? Really?
Yeah, so the Gann Handbook actually doesn't in any way specifically ban nonviolent occupations or protests. As a matter of fact, it probably, actually, the handbook and the administration encourages this sort of challenge to authority, hopefully through nonviolent means. As for the civil rights curriculum in our 11th grade, you know, we teach that these sorts of protests are oftentimes long overdue. And this seems to be no exception.
On the subject, Rabbi Baker has made several statements.
Let me make this clear. The Gann administration does by no means encourage the vocal or physical protest of our own policies. However, this really is just the pluralistic system at work. We are an experiment for the future of the Jewish people and for Jewish schools everywhere. Can we resolve disputes between classes in nonviolent ways? Let's think about this week's Torah portion and how Israel deals with instructions from its leadership. Now, we all know nothing goes without a challenge. I think the best way to move through this is to have one significant debate and to establish a final position for the school on smart boards and for all other devices while we're at it.
And for the last time, nobody thinks your pun signs are cute or funny. They just look immature and childish. You're all just children. Every one of you.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
Hello, ladies. Guess who's back?
Back again.
Tell a friend.
But not just any friend.
Tell someone who listens.
Someone who glistens.
Forever there for you.
Ever to care for you.
Till the day of our deaths.
Till we breathe our final breaths.
Will you be there?
One time, I was shopping in the supermarket looking for a box of fettuccine. When I finally found one, I, of course, checked for a Heckscher. I saw one I didn't recognize. But luckily, at that moment, a man with a kippah walked down the aisle. I asked, "Man with a kippah, is this Heckscher reliable?" And he responded,
"This Heckscher's pretty reliable, but why do you care? You're wearing pants."
That was Pluralism Time with Naomi Lieberman and guest star Tyler Crane. Thank you so much for joining us.
So did you see the hot guy panel in 17 magazine last week?
Yeah, Eduardo had some killer advice.
Yeah, that helped me out.
Yeah, it did.
Yes!
Reflections on that?
Yeah, I'll have a turkey club on Marble Rye, please.
Did you hear about the new iTosh?
I sure did.
Are you gonna get one?
Probably, are you?
I already have one.
Damn it, always ahead of the times.
I know.
When we set out to create the iTosh, we wanted to create something unique, something no one had ever done before.
The project really started when we saw the need and desire from the people of the school and from the larger Jewish community.
The design is inspired by thousands of Hamantaschen from across the globe.
We really put a lot of thought and passion into this product, and jelly.
It's a really unassuming and beautiful product, with so many features. It's amazing the jelly doesn't just pop out.
We have thoroughly taste-tested this product since its inception oh so long ago.
We are committed to producing only the best products for our consumers.
It's thinner.
I've had the privilege of beta testing this product, and I have to tell you, it is like no other.
Buttery.
I was blown away by the features and the supreme quality of the dough and jelly.
I can't stress enough how amazed I am with this product.
If I had to describe it in one word, it would be
wow.
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 It's truly magical.
Revolutionary!
It is so good.
I have the utmost confidence in the managerial team on this product. They are true professionals.
Liam was so excited about this project, he really took the lead.
Sarah's got everything under control.
We have class.
Yes. It's a classy product.
No, like, I have class now. It's 12:40. Lunch is over.
Oh.
You know, Steve Jobs once said that the consumer doesn't know what they want in a product until they actually have it. That's what we've done with the iTosh.
Call me Miss Shugana.
God gave the Israelites the Torah, but way back before the Israelites even knew about God. Did they even really want the Torah? No, because they did not know about it. That's what we've done with the iTosh.
It has angry birds.
Yes.
And before Purim, did people know they wanted a Hamantaschen? No! Because it did not exist!
And it also has Tempo Run!
Yes!
And did people know that they wanted the Adash? No! Because we just announced it! You're welcome! And oh yeah!
Oh, Apple, I get it.
It's kosher. Boom shakalaka!
Remind me to do this again.
Our next segment is Country of the Day!
You said it, girlfriend.
Cameroon.
We've all been around Gann for various amounts of time, and we've all heard people say things. So, with that, I bring to you things that Gann kids say.
Is this gonna be on the test? Do these look like real pants? Feel them, they're kinda like real pants. Can we have class outside?
No.
Do I look out of dress code? Wait, go back, No, go back, please. Is it due in class on Thursday or at 11:59?
Can you watch a movie?
I'm not texting. Or at 5. Do you know if it's muffin day? Do you have any gum?
Can I use my phone as a calculator?
Or on Friday?
It has a calculator on it.
Or in 2 weeks. Why don't we have a football team?
No.
Is this gonna be on the final?
Is this gonna be open note?
Does it look like I'm awake?
Can it be open note?
My printer broke.
Can it be a group quiz?
We have a Shabbaton this weekend. We can't have homework. Do you have any gum? How about now? What do I want? How come there are no cute guys again? There is no good candy. I feel the community. If I get my minus, will I still get into college? Do these look like real pants? What do I want? Do they feel like real pants? The chocolate croissants do not look very good today. This is not muffin day. I covered my shoulders. Do you know we have an essay due today?
I'm actually doing it right now.
I think I'm just gonna do it during class. The freshman boys are so hot. They have so much homework. Sophomore boys are so hot. Senior boys are like, whatever. Pluralism. My Hebrew teacher isn't here. Do you want to go to Panera? Dr. Colson. Wikipedia isn't a credible source? Does student council do anything? The Hassenfeld rumor wedding was like the biggest thing ever. I mean, I guess it's okay because Kobe's so cute. Muffins! I don't know where my backpack is. Can this be an open note test? Does this look too short? I think I lost my black North Face at the Shabbaton. Reed, do you have any gum? Does anyone have any gum? I'd wear this to Temple. Is it J-Block right now? Do you want to go get Panera? How about now?
Lastly, we'd like to say our goodbyes. This might be our last episode, but it's definitely our last episode.
Hopefully. Just kidding. To all the viewers out there, it's been a great run. We put in 110% every single day, every time down. And we know that you'll do the same.
The two anchors who were chosen for next year. Thank you for watching. This has been a GNN special update.
I'm Joe Samper.
And I'm Lauren Gluck.
One love.
Let's go, guys.
We're not recording.
He's not recording. He says he's not recording. See, look, all you people in the audience, you're all gonna see my face in like a couple weeks or whatever, because he was actually recording. Everybody, yeah. Rock your body, yeah. Everybody, yeah, rock your body right. Backstreet's back, alright. Hey, now, oh my God, we're back. Old Spice, it's for Jews too. Brothers, sisters, everybody say. Are we clear?
Yeah, we're good, go.
Sarah? Will you go to prom with me?
Wait, which Sarah? There's like 100 Sarahs in school.
Sarah Waxman. There's only one Sarah Waxman.